worry, Lizzie. I don't reckon you'll go following the tea leaves again. You just go with your own feelings. You'll get it all back.
Bea, I got problems.
No, you wouldn't have after losing all that money.
I've worked out how much money I got. Bea, I took too many bets. I can't pay off.
Lizzie!
Bea, what am I gonna do?
You don't trust anybody, do you?
Sometimes it's better not to.
What you owe us.
Yeah, no holding out on us.
What am I gonna do, Bea?
There's no point crying about it, Lizzie. The bets you let them make were ridiculous.
Well, if that's all you're gonna say, I told you so. Well, you needn't bother.
Now, just a minute, you bad-tempered old bugger.
Well, who am I gonna pay and who am I gonna leave? I've only got enough to pay some of them. What am I gonna say to the ones I can't pay?
Well, you're better off keeping them all happy. Now, why don't you just give them back their original bets and give them IOUs for the rest?
Well, that's a good idea. That might keep some of them off me back. I'll go and get the dough. You gonna give me a hand?
Yeah, I'll be with you in a tick, love.
Where's Lizzie gone?
She's gone to fetch her money.
Oh, goody, goody. It'd be nice to feel rich for a change,
now,
eh?
Now, just listen to me a minute, you lot. Lizzie's in a bit of strife. She can't afford to pay you all she owes you.
You mean she's going to welsh on us?
No, of course she's not. She'll give you back your original bets and she'll give you IOUs for the rest. And there'll be no belly aching about it, you understand?
Mm.
Now, come on, you know Lizzie will be all right for the rest of the dough when she can.
Yeah, she will be.
Yeah. No worries with Lizzie.
Good. I knew you'd all see it my way.
G'day.
Well, what's bugging you?
Hey?
You look like a man with something on his mind. What's the matter? Vera giving you a hard time, is she, mate?
No, I'm getting on fine. I told you, you don't know her.
Yeah, well, I'll leave all that up to you. Well, if it's not Vera, what's the problem?
Oh, it's no problem. I'm just thinking about Gaffney.
Gaffney? Mm. Does Vera know about this?
Now, I think Gaffney is going to be more help to us in the future.
What, with the Needs Committee, you mean?
Well, all sorts of things. Actually, B. Smith's more help to us as far as the committee's concerned.
Yeah, well, that may be, but what's all this about Gaffney? Why should she suddenly change?
Well, I just think she's going to be more help to us in the future. Which reminds me, I've got to dash out and pay a few bills. I'll see you later.
Yeah, right, I'll mind the fort for you.
Good,
Morning, sir.
Quite dead.
Taking something in?
Mm.
Yes, a hip flask.
Afternoon tea.
It's not lock-up time yet, is it?
No, not yet.
I've got what you wanted. Now, what have you got for me?
Depends on what you're after.
You know what I'm after, Gaffney. You know our deal. Information.
Yeah, well, there's not much happening at the moment.
Too bad.
Hey, listen, there is one thing.
But I better have proof.
Well, this is something you'll be able to prove real easy.
What?
Lizzie's running the book.
Oh, big deal.
You're not going to let her get away with it, are
you? There's no harm in it, even if I do believe you.
But it's true.
What, some poor old woman with heart trouble running around, keeping pace with running a book?
That's one of the reasons they chose her. Who'd think it was her? It's a good cover. Okay. I've come up with the information. Now, what about your end of the bargain?
Oh, turn it up, Gaffney. That's not worth a bottle of scotch. You'll have to do a lot better than that.
We had a deal. I would have known I couldn't have trusted you. You won't get another bloody thing out of me.
All right. Here's your scotch. Now, look, if you come up with any worthwhile information, you pass it on, all right?
Sure I will. Now I know you can keep your end of a bargain.
Yeah, well, don't you forget it.
Lock-up time.
Mm.
just haven't been as caring as perhaps they could have been, but you've got to learn to forgive them for that. You mustn't feel any resentment. It'll only hurt you. Let it go. It's not worth hanging on to.
I don't want to hate them. I'm really trying not to.
Well, that's the way. Well, what's happened to my help?
Sorry.
You must remember some good things about them.
Not about Dad. He never really had any time for me. Always sent me away when I tried to talk to him. Mum, well, she was all right, I guess. If it hadn't been for Dad, Mum and I probably would have got on pretty well. But she always buckled under to what he wanted.
She must have taken you places together when you were younger.
I remember once...
Must be Bob. Hello, darling.
Sorry I couldn't find my key. There's a hell of a lot of traffic on the way home. I thought I'd never get here.
Well, dinner's nearly ready.
Good. Hello, Nick.
You were telling me about your mother?
No, it doesn't matter now.
Well, are we eating out tonight?
Oh, there's no need. I've got a casserole in the fridge. Just heat it up.
You're a model of efficiency, madam.
Anything wrong with that?
Oh, did I say there was? That was supposed to be a compliment. You seem a bit touchy tonight.
Do I? Sorry.
Hey, come on. What's up?
I wasn't aware that anything was up. You apparently think there is.
Is it anything to do with Gaffney?
I don't know what you mean.
Well, you must have wondered what I was doing in her cell when you came to lock up.
I thought we'd decided not to talk about the prison at home.
Well, I think we ought to make an exception in this case till we get it all straight.
Is there something to get straight?
Well, if you're not interested...
Well, you can tell me if you want.
I got some information from her.
In return for placing those bets, I suppose?
Yep.
Anything important?
No, not really. But if something important does come up, I'm sure she'll tell us. I told you, it's worth cultivating someone like Gaffney.
She'll probably just string you along with useless information. I mean, what did she tell you today?
Lizzie Birdsworth is running a book.
A book?
Yeah, but she didn't have any proof.
If it's true, we'll soon find proof. We've got to put a stop to this immediately.
Yeah, well, it's my day off tomorrow, so I won't be doing much about it. Besides, why worry? There's no real harm in it.
Of course there is. It's against the rules and it has to be stopped.
Well, you're going to have to find your own proof.
That shouldn't be too hard, now that I know what I'm looking for.
I don't know what you're so happy about. How long do you think those women are going to be satisfied with your IOUs?
Oh, they seem quite happy. Anyway, I'll sort that all out tomorrow.
Oh, yeah? How are you going to do that?
Just a little plan I got. Guaranteed to even things out.
Oh, yeah? Just like Hammerhead was guaranteed to win that race.
Oh, this is going to be different.
Yeah? Well, what's the point of that? No use betting with yourself.
I'm going to bet all the women I owe. I'm going to bet them that I can pick 6 horses out of 8 races.
6 winners? You've got to be kidding.
I know I can do it.
Oh, and how can you be sure of a thing like that, Lizzie? Look, no matter how good they look, they can still be beaten. And if you're not careful, you'll end up with twice as many debts as you've got already.
No, I won't. I know what I'm doing. This system's foolproof.
Ready, Nick?
Wait a sec.
Have a good day, darling.
You too, darling. Look, don't worry about dinner for me tonight. I'll be late home. I've got to take out an important client.
Do you want to bring them home to dinner?
No, better not. Look, we've got a lot to discuss. Oops. And it'd be easier for just the two of us, okay? Darling, have you seen my appointment book?
Well, you were looking at it in bed last night. Yes, I must make a move, too.
Take the dishes on the sink. Is that all right?
Oh, yes. Thank you, Nick. I really do appreciate it. When you're working full time, housework becomes a bit of a drag.
I don't mind helping you.
Look, if Bob's going to be late tonight, I think I'll stay at the office and catch up on some work. You can find yourself tea, can't you?
Sure.
Right, now, Murray and Abbott, where are you?
You're on garden duty. Gaffney, you're on cleaning duty. The rest of you know what you're doing, so hop to it.
Oh, change.
You'll never guess what's happened.
Well, you'd better tell me then.
My cassette has turned up large as life back in my cell.
Oh, we must have scared whoever took it and given it back.
Still like to know who took it.
Yeah, so would I. I'll tell you one thing, though. When it went missing, there was a cassette in it. That's gone.
Well, I still think it was Margo.
Well, what would you want with a cassette without a player?
That's what I was wondering.
I tell you, I got a bottle of scotch, the real stuff.
Yeah? And who gave you that? Your fairy godmother.
It doesn't matter where it came from. I got it, that's the main thing. If you stick with me, I'll share it with you.
Look, I'm not risking B coming down on me for that. Even if you have got scotch.
Of course I've got it, you silly bitch.
Well, you better drink it then, hadn't you?
You're off your rocker, Lizzie.
She's only joking, aren't you?
No, I'm not. I reckon I can pick 6 horses out of 8 races. And I'm going to bet you double or nothing on what I owe you. Now, you going to be in it?
I'll be in it. Might as well win a bit before they take you away in the giggle truck.
Good on you, Hayes. Now, will you keep knit while I write down the names?
You're mad, Lizzie. You're going to end up dead broke. How can anybody expect to pick 6 winners out of 8?
Oh, I just feel a bit lucky today, that's all. Now, who's going to bet me?
OK. Here you go.
Oh, I'm not going to do it right now. I've got to think about it first. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll pick 1 horse out of each race and I'll put its name in the tin. And then after all the races are over, you can look and you can tell me if I was right.
I don't believe this. Surely you're going to give yourself better odds than that.
Oh, it'll be OK, B. Do you want to keep the IOUs?
Oh, all right. Listen, Lizzie, are you...
So are you sure she's going to be all right? I'd hate to see her get more strife.
Yeah, well, so would I, but the silly old bugger's determined to go through with it.
Psst! Vinegar!
Back to work.
Anything wrong, Miss Bennett?
Why do you ask, Birdsworth?
Oh, I just thought you looked a bit funny, that's all.
Well, that depends entirely on your sense of humour, Lizzie. Now, I have known strong men to faint at the sight of Vera's face.
I'm warning you, Smith. Now get back to work, all of you.
We've been working all day, Miss Bennett. I didn't think you'd mind if we had a bit of an extra smoko.
Don't bet on it, Birdsworth.
Miss Johansson is here, Mr. Morris.
Oh, shove it, will you?
Miss Johansson.
I'm pleased to meet you.
How do you do, Mr. Morris?
No, please, call me Bob.
Then you must call me Anna. Mm.
Did you enjoy your flight, Anna?
Oh, it was most pleasant. From what I see in your country, it's very beautiful.
Yes, it is, isn't it? I hope you get a chance to see something while you're here.
Do you want me for anything, Mr. Morris?
Yes, Mrs. Russell. I should be taking Miss Johansson to lunch. I don't know how long we'll be gone, so would you just take messages for the rest of the afternoon? And could you file that report on my desk, please?
Excuse me.
I've booked a table at a very pleasant little restaurant. I'm sure you'll like it.
Good. I'm looking forward to having a long discussion with you. My father has instructed me to make the decision as to whether an association between us would be of mutual benefit.
I'm sure it will. Who was that?
Hmm?
The good-looking bird with Mr. Morris.
Oh, she's the Swedish contact. Her father's a big furniture manufacturer. Mr. Morris wants to get the rights to import their furniture over here.
Oh, yes, that's right. What do I do with these? I'm supposed to initial them.
Oh, I think you better just leave them. I think he'll be with Miss Johansson for the rest of the afternoon. I wonder what he'll have to do to impress her.
I hope you enjoyed the meal.
It was delicious. Not at all what I expected. Neither are you.
Well, what did you expect?
Well, I have been told that Australian men are very loud and rude and eat meat pies.
Yes, well, not all of us.
No, so I see. It is a pleasant surprise.
And it's a pleasant change for me to be having a business lunch with such a charming and attractive woman.
Thank you. I think our relationship will be a rewarding one.
Well, I shall certainly do everything in my power to make sure it is.
Perhaps you'll be so kind as to show me around the city.
It will be my pleasure, Anna.
And mine? I always enjoy mixing pleasure with business.
Well, pick me horse for the first race. No, you're not going to look. I don't want anyone betting on my chips.
No use betting with you anyway, Lizzie, because you've got no money to pay out with.
Oh, don't worry. I'll be out of the red before the races are over today.
Well, I still say there's no way you can pick 6 winners out of 8 races. It's impossible.
Ah, we'll see.
Okay, in a few minutes, we're going to cross to Ron Weeks for a report on the track.
I'll leave it alone, Dor. You can read all the names after the last race.
Hey, Stu, it's almost time for the last race.
Yeah, why won't you let us have a look and see if you got any right yet?
Because you got to do it proper. We'll look at them afterwards.
Will you shut up at start?
Around the turn and it's bottle top the leader from Dasher Boy and Demon's Frolic, and they've ticked away a good 6 lengths.
What's going on here? Oh, Lizzie's bet us all double or nothing that she can pick 6 winners out of 8 races today.
Yeah, how does she reckon she's going to do that?
Oh, I don't know, but she's picked a horse in each race and put their names in the tin.
Hasn't told you which one she's picked, though, has she?
No, she reckons she can't tell us that till after the races are over.
Yeah, I thought so.
She's taking you for a ride. It's a con.
Oh, bugger off, Margo, just because you're not bookie anymore.
She's having you on, I'm telling you.
If we wanted the dog to bark, we would have rattled the chain.
You're probably in it with her.
Shut up, we're trying to listen to this.
Do your bloody dough, then. What a rat bag. Letting an old bag like that pull one of the oldest contracts in the business.
What's going on here?
Oh, gambling. Miss Bennett's just having a bit of a listen to the races. No harm in that, is there?
You seem to be right in the middle of things, Birdsworth. You're obviously the bookie.
Oh, no, Miss Bennett. We weren't making no bets. Nothing like that.
Really? What have you got behind your back, Smith?
Nothing.
Haven't you? Well, show me your hands.
Out of my way.
A race form. And IOUs, all signed by you, Birdsworth. Still say there's no gambling going on?
Oh, we was just having a little flutter, Miss Bennett. We've got to have something to pass the time. I mean, there's no harm in that.
You got your work to do that. Now get back to work, all of you. You come with me, Birdsworth.
Oh, come on, Vera. No point in making a federal case out of it.
Now get back to work, all of you, or I'll have you in front of the governor. Come on, Birdsworth.
Poor old Lizzie.
Well, let's see if she picked any winners, eh?
God.
Oh, what? Oh, bloody heck, she's picked 7.
That's incredible.
How did she do it?
I don't know, but she's done it.
Well, it means she doesn't owe anybody anything now.
Yeah, that'll get her off the hook.
Yeah.
A lot of good that's going to do Lizzie now.
Well, Terry was hoping that Gaffney might come to the party as far as the needs committee was concerned.
I could have told him not to waste his time. Gaffney told me some time ago she was not interested and never would be.
So it looks like the only way is through Smith.
Well, the women should be aware of the idea. At least I hope Bryant's told them. But I think we should take things quietly for a while.
What do you mean, don't make waves?
Yes, I think all the staff should be advised to handle the women with kid gloves until further notice.
I've got Birdsworth here. She's been running a book. I caught her red-handed.
Oh, Miss Bennett, I would like...
Inside, Birdsworth. Here are the IOU slips, all signed by Birdsworth.
Well, Lizzie, I wouldn't have picked you as a bookie.
Well, it's just something to break the boredom, Mrs. Davidson. I can't understand what all the fuss is about.
Because it's against the rules, that's why. The IOUs give you the names of the other women who are obviously involved.
I'm inclined to agree with Lizzie, Miss Bennett. I don't think we should make too much fuss. I see that most of the IOUs are for small amounts of money.
I can't see that the amounts make any difference. These women aren't even supposed to have any money. I think there should be an investigation into how they got it in the first place.
Yes, well, the women have always managed to get small amounts of money into the prison before, Miss Bennett. You know that. I don't think there's any point in having a full-scale investigation over such a minor matter.
Shall I take Birdsworth to solitary, Mrs. Davidson?
Oh, God, I can't be stuck in there on my own. I've got a crook ticker, you know. I'm going to have a nasty turn at any minute.
That's quite correct. I don't think Birdsworth shall be put into solitary.
Then what punishment do you intend, Mrs. Davidson?
Lizzie, you realise you've done the wrong thing and must be punished. Well, there's been a need for someone in the maternity wing. I'll have you transferred there for a time.
Oh, okay, Mrs. Davidson. Whatever you say.
Surely you intend to do something...
You've heard my decision, Miss Bennett.
Well, come on, Doreen. Give me a hand.
Well, what are we going to do with it? I mean, if they start searching, they're going to search all of us.
I think they'll be too busy concentrating on Lizzie.
Oh, Lizzie, what's happening?
I come to pack.
You
in Shanghai.
Well, they can't do that. Now I've been transferred to maternity for a few days. I don't really mind. I love kids.
Oh, is that all they're going to do to you?
Yeah. Mrs. Davidson was beaut. She put old Vera in a place.
Well, how long do you reckon you'll be there?
A couple of weeks. But I'll be okay. You just do your best to get me back. At least I don't owe no one nothing anymore.
Yeah. You picked 7 winners, Lizzie.
Yeah, and I'd have picked 8 if I'd been lucky.
How did you do that? Was it a con like Margo said?
Of course it was. Only don't tell the others, will you, Dor?
Yeah, but I give me money too, you know.
Yes, I know, love. But you don't mind, do you? For your old mate.
I suppose not.
Just tell us how you did it. Well, first of all, I looked in the racing guide and picked what I thought was a winner for the last race. Then I wrote down the name, pretending that was my choice for the first race. After each race was run, I only had to write down the name of the horse who won. Then when all my choices were checked, I had to have 7 winning horses. Maybe 8 if I'd made a good guess in the last race.
Well, you old shifty. I knew there had to be something in it, but I don't like you working cons on the women, Lizzie.
Oh, but I gave them all back their bets, Bea. Nobody's lost anything. They seemed happy enough.
Yeah, nobody's no worse off. I don't think.
Don't worry about it, Doreen. All right, Lizzie. Nothing I can do about it now, but I don't think you should be the bookie from now on.
Suits me.
Listen, I've put your dough in there just in case the screws decide to start searching.
Don't think they'll bother. Mrs. Davidson didn't seem to think there was much to worry about.
Still can't work out how come she let you off so lightly. Mm.
You're right, Birdsworth. You two are supposed to be at lunch.
We're just saying goodbye to Lizzie.
You're not going to smoke in maternity, are you, Birdsworth?
Oh, well, well...
Well, just leave them here.
Or they might get pinched. I'll tell you what, Mr. Fletcher, you look after them for me.
Well, just leave them here with Bea or Doreen.
Oh, go on, Mr. Fletcher. You don't mind doing an old lady a favour now, do you?
All right, Lizzie, I'll look after them for you. Come on.
Well, if Margo has any sense at all, she'll steer clear of us today.
Yeah. Listen, I've been thinking.
Oh, God, Doreen, we've had enough shocks for one day.
No, this is important. I reckon Margo lagged on Lizzie.
Go on.
Well, didn't it seem to you that Vera knew that Lizzie was the bookie already, even before she found the IOUs?
Yeah, that's true.
And I saw Margo giving Terry money, didn't I, to put a bet on for her. So why would he do her any favours?
Well, maybe she was selling him some information.
Yeah, well, that's what I reckon. I think she's got a sort of deal going with him.
And he and old Vinegar are on together.
Mm-hmm.
Margot's told Terry, and Terry's told Vera.
God, Doreen, I thought I'd been through all that.
Well, it's true. Margot's got a lot coming to her.
And I reckon she's the one who nicked your tape recorder, Jude.
Yeah, but why would she want to do that?
Well, the cassette's missing, isn't it? She must have wanted to record something. And that's the only thing I can't figure out.
Not unless she was planning to use it against somebody.
What about Terry? Maybe she's going to blackmail him.
Oh, Stewart, that'd make her dangerous, wouldn't it? With a screw under her thumb.
Very dangerous. You know, if Gaffney keeps getting up my nose like this, we might just have to fix her once and for all.
Come in. Nick, what are you doing here?
I bet you haven't eaten yet.
Oh, well, as a matter of fact, I haven't. Why?
I knew you'd be working straight through, so I brought you something to eat.
Nick, thank you. That's very nice of you.
You'd better eat it before it gets cold.
Well, I have an appointment, surely. I don't think I'll be able to finish all this.
Oh, at least you've eaten something.
Have you eaten?
Hmm. I suppose Mr. Morris is enjoying himself in some fancy restaurant, eh?
Well, probably. He's entertaining a client.
Do you, say you've got a happy marriage?
Yes, of course we have. Very happy. Well, don't you think so?
Hmm. It's an open sort of a marriage, isn't it?
Open? I don't know what you mean.
Well, you know, plenty of freedom on both sides.
Well,
I suppose it depends on what sort of freedom you're referring to.
Well, you know, sexual freedom.
I don't think that's a subject I wish to discuss with you, Nick.
I'm sorry. It's just that I... Sorry.
Now, let's just get the record straight. I don't think the question of sexual freedom would arise between myself and Bob. As I said before, we're both very happily married. Now, let's just leave it at that, shall we? What to put the question into your head in the first place? Told you I wouldn't be able to finish all this. I'm afraid you'll have to go. Meg Morris speaking. Yes, send him up, will you, please? Thanks for the food, Nick. I'll see you tonight. Terry?
Oh, I was hoping to have tea ready by the time you got home. I'm way behind schedule.
Oh, you needn't have bothered. I would have cooked us a meal.
No, it's my day off. Besides, I'm a pretty good cook, you know. Had to be when I was on my own.
Well, you're not alone now.
No. Hey, look, you sit down, relax, and I'll pour us some drinks.
Well, it's nice to be waited on for a change. Well, aren't you going to ask me how my day was?
All right, I'll bite. How was your day?
I caught Birdsworth red-handed doing her bookie act.
You made up your mind to get her, didn't you?
Well, I told you we can't have things like that going on. Not that Mrs. Davidson seemed very concerned.
Huh?
She simply transferred Birdsworth to the maternity block.
Good. Glad to hear it.
What do you mean? Birdsworth deserved to be punished. Mrs. Davidson's too soft. I've known that all along. What really puzzled me was Jim. He seemed to be backing her up.
Well, perhaps they both realise there's no harm in an old woman taking a few bets. Look, I'm sorry I told you about Lizzie.
I don't understand you at all, Terry. Just where would you draw the line? How far would you let the women go?
Well, I'm not a complete idiot, you know. There are things I wouldn't allow. Drugs, violence, any situation that would lead to a riot. I'd come down heavy on that. But some of these things can be avoided if you just treat the women like human beings.
But they're not. They're criminals.
What do you want to do, Vera? Put more and more pressure on them? I tell you, you increase the pressure and you're going to have trouble. They're going to be bitter and angry.
Well, they're not meant to be happy.
Look, if you back them into a corner, Vera, there's only one way they can go, and that's out, through us. And that means someone is going to get hurt.
What are you advocating? Patting them on the heads? Pandering to them?
All I'm saying is that you can try and help them, and by helping them, help us. Look, turn a blind eye now and again, and you'll find them easier to
manage. No, you're wrong. We'd never be able to keep discipline.
Look, are you trying to tell me that because Lizzie Birdsworth puts a few bets here and there that we're going to lose control of the women? They're bored, for crying out loud. They need entertainment.
Your thinking is way out of line.
Oh, terrific. Enjoy your bloody tea.
Oh, Terry, where are you going?
Somewhere where I can get some peace and quiet.
Bob not home yet?
No, he's not.
He'll be tired. I know I am. It's good to catch up on my work, though. And thank heavens for that food.
It's all right.
I know it's late, but I think I'll sit up and wait for Bob to see how he got on today. Oh.
I'll sit with you.
Oh, no, it's all right. You ought to go to bed. Get a good night's sleep. Be bright and alert for the morning.
Don't worry about me. I don't miss much.
Oh, I know that, but you want to get on in this job, don't you?
Wouldn't want to embarrass Mr. Morris, would we?
Nick, Bob is only trying to help you. I think he's proven that. Now, you've been fair to him.
I'm not rude to him or anything, am I?
No, I know you're not, but... Well, couldn't you just try a little harder? Oh, well, I'm going to make a cup of coffee. Would you like one?
Oh, yes, please. I'll make it if
no,
you
no,
like.
No, it's all right. I'll get it. Be my poor, overworked husband. Lost his key again.
Don't worry about the coffee. I'm going to bed.
Hello, darling. Come on in. Well, how was your day? Well,
this client's a real live wire. She wants to see the whole of Australia.
She?
Yeah. And what a business brain.
Well, what about the rest of her? Good as her brain?
Well, you know, typically Swede. And nice if you like that kind of thing.
Yes, well, I've heard about those Swedish birds.
Darling, this is strictly business. Now, I'm going to have to see quite a bit of her if we want that contract. It could mean a lot of money for the company.
Well, just hope it remains business, eh?
Now, why would I want the imported stuff when the homegrown is so good, eh?
Wonder how Lizzie's going in maternity.
Yeah, probably selling the kids watered down formula by now.
Still can't work out how come Davo was so light on it.
Oh, I don't know, Davo's not a bad old stick.
Yeah.
Hard at it as usual, I see, ladies.
Ooh, at least he called us ladies.
Yeah, now some of us might take offence at that.
All right, cut out the nonsense. I need two volunteers to work in the kitchen.
Ugh.
Well, come on, wouldn't somebody like a change of scenery?
Yeah, I would. Give me a chance to say hello to Lizzie.
Well, I'd offer to go with you, honey, but the microwave ovens affect my pacemaker.
And besides, I don't want to be left here with no one to talk to. Or that lot.
Well, I'm still one short. Well?
I'll do it. Anything to get out of this joint.
All right. Gaffney and Burns, to the kitchen.
Don't let that bitch talk herself into your good books.
No worries, B.
See you later.
Trust Gaffney, sticking her bloody beak in where it isn't wanted as usual.
But it got rid of them for a while.
I'll tell you what, Gaffney is pushing her luck just a bit too far.
What are you going to do about it?
Don't you worry. I'll think of something.
Come on, Dor. Don't tell me you're going to keep giving me the silent treatment. Look, we used to be good mates, remember? Look at all the fun that we had when we were doing the powder. And I went along with the escape everything tonight. Did my best to help it go all right. So give us a break now. Look, come on. Bee won't know. Needn't be frightened. I won't let on to her.
Bee's got nothing to do with it. It's you who roughed me up and you've done your dash with me, Margo.
Listen, I got a bottle of scotch in my cell. I've only drunk a bit of it. I'll share the rest with you.
Scotch? And how'd you get that lag into a screw, I suppose?
Might have done a screw a favour, but I wouldn't lag, you know that.
Oh, like hell I do. You lagged on Lizzie. That's how vinegar caught her out, you know. And Bee's a wake-up to you, and sooner or later she's going to get you good and proper. And you needn't bother trying to talk to me anymore, because as far as I'm concerned, you're not here.
Hey, did you pinch anything to eat?
Who do you think I am? Crook?
Hmm? What happened to ferret-faced Gaffney?
Still in the kitchen.
Uh-huh.
But she is in no hurry to come back here.
Yeah, well, I'm not surprised. Hey, you see Lizzie?
Yeah. And, you know, she really likes being in maternity. It means she can fuss over all the kids, you know?
Yeah, it'll probably do her good, you know. Things are getting a bit toey here for a while.
Yeah, well, there wouldn't be any tension around here if it wasn't for Gaffney. Did she try and talk you around, Doreen?
Yes, she did. She reckons she's got a bottle of scotch, but I don't know whether it's true or not.
You know, she told Hazel the same thing. I'm beginning to think she must have it.
Yeah, well, if that's true, it's got to be one of the screws.
Yeah, we know who that'd be, don't we? And why?
Yeah, well, I told her that we knew she'd lagged on Lizzie.
Well, don't tell her anything. We want her to keep wondering what we're thinking.
Yeah, kind of drive her up the wall. No one talking to her or anything.
Yeah, and once she's up the wall, she might just fall off. Like Humpty Dumpty. Or maybe just one tiny push.
You want to see Mr. Morris?
Oh, yes, Nick. I can't get away. I'm waiting on an important overseas phone call. I'd like you to take my car and pick up a client for me, will you? Look, there's the address. Please.
Who do I ask for?
Miss Johansson. Tell her I'm sorry I can't pick her up personally, but I'll be ready to take her to lunch by the time you get back. Oh, Nick. Best behavior, remember. She's very important to us.
You're the young man that Mr. Morris sent, aren't you, Mr. Clark?
That's right. Nick Clark.
So kind of Mr. Morris to phone and let me know he couldn't come immediately. He's a wonderful man, isn't he?
Mm.
Oh, thank you. I'm very impressed with your beautiful city. Mr. Morris has gone out of his way to show as much of it to me as possible. Oh, I certainly made my stay here a very pleasant one. I hadn't expected him to be such a warm and responsive man.
Hello?
Harrison.
Yes, what is it, Smith?
Got a minute? I was just wondering why you gave Margo that bottle of scotch. She'll probably use it against you, you know.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Ah, pull the other leg. She's been selling information to you, hasn't she? That's how come Lizzie got caught so easily.
The way I hear it, Lizzie Birdsworth was caught red-handed. Now, if you're going to run a book, you don't flaunt it in front of the officers.
Lizzie wasn't flaunting anything. Now, why make such a big deal out of it? There's probably a book run in every prison in this country, so why not here?
Why not here?
You mean you're not against her?
Well, I don't see it does any harm.
Then why punish Lizzie at all?
Look, it's not my decision. Why don't you go and see Mrs. Davidson about it? See what she says.
Oh, I know what she'd say.
Well, why don't you try? You might be surprised.
You're joking.
Well, why don't I go and speak to her? She can only say no. I mean, what have you got to lose? Smith wants to see you, Mr. Davidson.
Right, bring her in, would you?
Come on, Smith.
Yes, Smith, what is it?
It's about Lizzie, Mrs. Davidson. Look, it's not fair she's been transferred away from her mates. You know where all she's got.
Lizzie broke the rules and she had to be punished. That's all there is to it.
Well, there's no point talking to you then, is there? What you say goes, and we can either like it or lump it. And you're the one that said your door was always open.
Mrs. Davidson has made a time available, Smith, so come on, what's your complaint?
Well, I thought I might be able to discuss something, but fat chance, no one gives a damn what we think.
Smith, stay right where you are. If you have something to say, let's hear it.
Well, what's the point? You're the governor. I'm just one of the scum. You make the decisions. What does it matter what I've got to say about
it? I am interested to hear what you have to say, and I am prepared to meet you on equal ground.
Equal ground?
There has been no attempt at a discussion. When you came in here, you were spouting criticism. If you have something to discuss, sit down and we will talk.
All right. But when we came to you as a committee, you wouldn't listen to us then.
Your efforts in the past have always degenerated into rabble-rousing. I'm always willing to discuss something if it is presented in an orderly fashion.
Okay, then. How about letting us run a book? Are you prepared to discuss that? Mr. Harrison seemed to think you would be.
Come off it, Smith. You know that that's impossible. I'm surprised you'd even bother Mrs. Davidson with it.
Just a moment, Mr. Fletcher. What you're saying is you want to run a betting system in the prison.
Yeah. Lizzie was running a book. Look, no one can really do their dough because nobody's got very much. It's just a bit of harmless fun, that's all.
I see.
But I don't suppose you'd be prepared to okay that, though.
Oh, I don't know. I may be persuaded to overlook such a thing if it were well run and there was no trouble caused. But you would have to be discreet about it.
Mrs. Davidson, there are rules...
Rules can be modified, Mr. Fletcher. In fact, if you women were prepared to come and talk matters over with me, you might be surprised at what I would allow.
Hello.
Hi.
You were very late in last night.
Yeah.
You didn't have to sleep on the sofa, you know. You were still asleep when I left for work this morning, so I didn't wake you.
Thanks.
Look, I'm sorry we argued last night. I think we should stick to what we said and not talk about Wentworth at home.
Yeah, I'm sorry we argued too. Look, Vera, I meant what I said. You've got to change your attitude.
Look, Terry, I've never been very good at relating to people. I really feel that the women need disciplining. But I'll try not to be so harsh.
Vera, look, you'll find them a lot easier to handle if you soften your attitude.
Well, you won't sleep on the sofa tonight, will you?
I've just been talking to Smith. She mentioned she'd had a discussion with you.
What'd she say?
Oh, just that you suggested she talk to me about a certain matter. I think she was surprised I was prepared to consider what she had to say. I believe Smith is now in a position to help us with the Needs Committee. Thank you for getting her to come and see me.
All right, Gaffney, I think it's about time we got a few things sorted out.
Oh, yeah? What?
About Harrison. Just steer clear of him. Don't go mucking things up.
Like what?
Like I think if we play our cards right, he could be very good for us.
He's been good to me already.
Oh, yeah? How?
Well, he's done me a few favours. And if he doesn't do exactly what I tell him to, I've got enough evidence to sink him for good.
Just lay off.
No way. I've got him right where I want him.
You do as I
say. Listen up, Smith. You should be in the recreation room with the others. Now get moving. I said get moving.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
Not you, Gaffney.
I think you're a little too sure of yourself in a number of areas, Gaffney. You better tread carefully or you're headed for a lot of trouble.
Where have you been, Smith?
Well, I've been talking to one of our protected animals. You should know who I mean. And I wouldn't bother if I were you because she's out to get you. And we've got a couple of scores to settle. If you've got any sense, you look the other way.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, where'd you disappear to?
I have been having afternoon tea with the governor.
Oh, really? Did you use the silver tea silver set?
Bloody right. No, seriously, I had an incredible talk with her.
How do you mean?
Well, she reckons if we do it properly, we can run a book.
Oh, you gotta be kidding.
No, I'm not. And if we play our cards right, we can get a whole lot of other things too.
Could we get Lizzie back?
I don't know, we can but try. Look, she just wants us to talk to her, to put things to her. I reckon we should form this needs committee we've been talking about.
Oh, come off it, B. When that sort of thing didn't work before, I don't see why it's gonna work now.
That's because we've never done it properly before. We've never approached Mrs. Davidson as equals.
Equals? How can we?
She'll let us. She did with me. Look, all she wants is a quiet life, and that gives us bargaining power. She reckons she'll consider any serious proposition we put to her. So, what do you say about that?
Did Bob say how long he'd be?
No. He's been out all afternoon with that Swedish woman. Probably won't be home till late.
Oh, I wish he'd rung me. Wouldn't have put dinner on till later. Oh, well, I suppose I can't get too annoyed. He does work awfully hard. That client of his is really wearing him out.
Not surprised.
What do you mean?
Well, she's a spunky lady, and she's flipped over Mr. Morris. I had to pick her up from a hotel today. She wouldn't stop talking about him. What a wonderful man he was. How warm and responsive.
Responsive?
That's what she said. I saw them leaving together. She was hanging off his arm.
Well, I suppose Bob can't help that. Then he could hardly shake her off. And she is an important client.
Seemed to me he was lapping it up.
Well, he'd have to pretend to, wouldn't he? He could hardly afford to insult her. She's very beautiful, you say.
A knockout.
Lucky Bob.
What do you think you're up to, Gaffney?
What are you talking about?
What have you been saying about me?
Don't you try anything with me. I've got evidence against you. I've got a tape of you saying you'll bring that scotch in for me. Even if you find it, I've made copies. You'd never find all of them.
Why? What do you want?
I want out of here. I want you to keep your part of the bargain and get me transferred to Barnhurst.
I didn't make that bargain with you.
No, but your girlfriend did. You've got to talk her into keeping her part of the bargain. Otherwise, a copy of that tape goes to Mrs. Davidson's office.
You're being very silly, Gaffney.
Oh, yeah? We'll see who's the silly one.
Hello? Hello? The hunter returns from the hills.
Hmm? I'd say the hunter is very well oiled.
Hmm?
You had a liquid lunch, have you?
Oh, yes, we had some wine and a few liqueurs.
Made quite an afternoon of it.
Yes, we were there for most of the afternoon, I come to think of it.
We?
Yes, me and client.
Oh, that Swedish girl.
Yes, Anna.
You two seem to be getting along very well.
Well, I told you, she's a very important client.
Would you like to bring her home to dinner one night?
Oh, no, darling, I don't want to bore you with all that business chatter.
Well, you've brought other clients home, I haven't minded. Or would Anna rather go to a restaurant?
She certainly enjoys high living, I tell you that.
Does she? Mm.
Oh, that's Anna, the one on the right. We had her taken at a restaurant. She wanted a photo to take home with her. It must have got mixed up with some papers I was showing.
Oh, then you do discuss some business, do you?
Gaffney?
give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare, awaken up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.